good at each other.
Thank you.
This is Social Dissonance. It is a durational concert. I have to inform you that we are being filmed. The film is being streamed online. The video over there is the live stream of Castle. It is happening at the same time. We would like to ask you if you can stay for the whole concert. It is important for a situation to be built here. We are trying to interpret the score which is over there. It is quite hard, so your contribution and interpretation will be very much appreciated. If you decide to leave at some point during the concert, we will ask you to give us some feedback in order for us to learn from you and improve. And also, I would like to inform you that today we are striking because of the extreme heat and the lack of proper air conditioning. So we would like to ask you to join our strike.
never allow me to see the videos that I see around. And it's a work of people. And on the screen you see the word that I don't really remember what it means, but it's been pinned also, and it's streamed on Periscope. And today there is a strike because of the lack of air conditioning. And if you want to leave, you have to give something back to the performer.
Do you want to give some feedback?
Sure.
Yeah. Tell us what you think is going on here, or what.
It's a hot room full of sweaty people.
Do you want people to join us in the marble room over there?
It didn't feel so cold when I touched it. I saw what you were doing. It seemed like a good move. But it's just so warm in here now. Everything is hot.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's all over me. I think it's even cooler outside at this point. Yeah, it's late in the day. I want to see what else is going on in the building.
Okay. How can we improve, fix the air conditioner?
We demand equal rights for the mental workers in Gaza and in Athens.
This is what I can see. This is what you're representing. That means to keep the same.
Oligarchy of internet and I think capitalism with internet and with these like mediums that we have, media that we have attached to our bodies, like cell phones and computers, found his way to ruling the world more than the government. So they basically rule us through the media. Smartphones and their social networks, data.
So you don't participate in all of that? Social media, internet?
For sure, I will participate because it's almost impossible not to participate. But I'm doing some research on like different authors, like Dan Mankiewicz, who's an American professor of the media art, and also he criticizes a lot these kind of databases that society we are living in, and also like the economy is pretty much ruled by algorithms and softwares that kind of predict the future of innocence. So we are going through some sort of metamorphosis that doesn't involve to transform like in the mythology in something else, like in nature, like in a natural character. But we are transforming in machines into machines. We are realigning in the machines the questions about our future. And this is scary if we lose the perception of our body and of ourselves, and we put everything in the idealization of ourselves into the social network, for example. I think.
So what do you do to fight that?
What do we do? I think, I'm reading also, like I was reading the paper, like a research that was written by, I don't remember who, but it was on Cambridge Analytics that was pretty much profiling all the Americans, and they did target advertised for their actions, so this is one of the reasons why Trump got elected. So it's so much into everything that what do you do? Like, what do you do? The only thing that you can do is develop your own awareness, your own consciousness, and avoid these kind of mechanisms. But you cannot avoid, like, yeah, you can choose not to be on Facebook and not to use Instagram, but if you have a smartphone, pretty much your data are triangulated by everybody. And so they know what to do, the algorithms know what to do, so pretty much they will try to sell you stuff in order to buy you like some things because you are in Athens or because you took a flight or whatever. So
why did you accept to be streamed?
Why did I accept to be streamed? Because I think it's part of the performance, and I think it's part of the process. So it's like using a medium that is, of course, some sort of data, but it's like in the present. It's not. I don't know. I'm not sure if the streaming stays in the database. It stays in the database. Well, now I put the face recommendation. Hello. But I think it's using a medium to say something through art that is supposedly is not capitalized.
So if it's for art, it's okay.
If it's for art, if it has a strong critique, it's okay because I mean, if you have something to say, you should use all the media that you are able to have to say something. But you need to say something. You have to, like, you need to have something to say, otherwise it's pointless.
Some people use social media to do exactly that.
That's true. Some people use social media to do exactly that, but a lot of people don't.
How can you say that it's not art? Like Kim Kardashian's do art with their lives. Maybe they're not aware of it, but they do.
I would not take such a celebrity as an example because it's not. The celebrities are few people in the world. You have to think about mass. So the problem doesn't come from the celebrities, it comes from the mass. Of course, a lot of people in the mass follow the celebrity, so the celebrity is actually pushing people to do something because they will copy the celebrity, people will copy the celebrity, and whatever. And I will not take a celebrity as an example.
We pushed you to do something, all of you, and you all did it.
Yeah.
And we're not celebrities.
So that's the point. Don't take celebrities as an example.
Actually, the point is don't take anybody as an example.
You still need archetypes to explain things, I think. So maybe you don't take a special, like one special person, like one person, but maybe you need to take actors repeat themselves in time, they will evolve. So I think the repetition in the patterns, like in time, can be a repetition, but it's always asking a different kind of association of patterns. So like it is still different. Like it's like DNA. Like DNA is a repetition because you still have some DNA from your parents. But it's an evolution of repetition. I don't know. Maybe I'm saying some bullshit, but probably I don't know.
He was a doctor. What's your opinion on that?
There is a problem that I do not speak very well the English language, and for this reason I cannot understand everything and I cannot express freely.
Would you help me with that? Do you speak Greek?
Of course, yes.
Εγώ την τη ρώτησα εάν μπορεί να υπάρξει προσωπικό και μου δείξω για αρχέτυπα τα οποία θα έχουμε ως παραδείγματα και μου της είπε ότι αν έχουμε αρχέτυπα άρα είμαστε όλοι μιμητές και μου λέει ότι δεν υπάρχει μίμηση, είναι σαν το DNA. Παίρνει ένα κομμάτι του παρελθόντος και εξελίσσει. I will try to translate from Greek to English.
Είναι γεγονός ότι η μνήμη είναι κονταχού παρούσα. Με την έννοια ότι πιθανότατα ο άνθρωπος είναι μια δέσμη από μνήμες.
It's a fact that memory
κονταχού παρούσα.
Omnipresent. Omnipresent. Thank you. And that life in human being is consecutive memories.
Και ότι πάνω σε αυτή τη μνήμη, ναι, εξελισσόμαστε και προσωπικά συμφωνώ, ναι, ότι όπως το DNA, έτσι, παρά την επανάληψη, υπάρχει η δυνατότητα μιας συνεχούς εξέλιξης σαν μια αενάως εξελισσόμενη σφύρα.
So he agrees that we are, like DNA, we as well evolve, like a spiral.
Ακριβώς. Αν υπάρχει ένα πολύ σημαντικό πράγμα το οποίο δεκαετίες τώρα και μάλιστα ίσως το μεγαλύτερο πνευματικό κεφάλαιο στην Ελλάδα σήμερα, ο Χρήστος Γιαμαράς, το φωνάζει εδώ και 40 χρόνια, είναι ακριβώς αυτή η ετερότητα του καθενός μας, η οποία όμως για να βιωθεί και να γίνει κατανοητή απαιτείται πρώτα να χτίσουμε μέσα μας μια σταθερή ταυτότητα.
Like a great Greek thinker, Christos Giannaras says when he first decades, our individuality, in order to be built, needs that every one of us has a concrete identity inside, and then all the influences will come.
Ευχαριστώ. Και γι' αυτόν τον λόγο είναι γεγονός ότι όπως προχωράμε, όπως ναι, στηριζόμαστε στην μνήμη, άλλο τόσο μπορεί να στηριχτούμε και στην ελπίδα για ένα όραμα καλύτερο, το οποίο αν και μελλοντικό, είναι μέσα μας συστατικό στοιχείο της σύμπανσης. Ας
use our memories in order to build anew, we can use the hope of things to come in order to create a better future.
Και με αυτή την έννοια, έτσι όπως ήταν στο κείμενο που μας δώσατε, εκεί είναι που ο ένας γίνεται το εγώ, γινόμαστε εμείς. Δεν θα είχε κανένα νόημα να μέναμε ένας με την έννοια αυτής της αποξένωσης, της πιθανής αλλοτρίωσης. Η αλλοτρίωση ήταν μια λέξη πάρα πολύ της μόδας πριν από 30 χρόνια. Τώρα πια σχεδόν την έχουμε ξεχάσει. Και παρά την αποξένωση, θυμόμαστε εκείνον τον Αρθούρο Ρεμπό, όταν είπε «Je, ανώτερο». Εγώ είναι
ένας άλλος θεωρώντας ανεξάρτητο. Βέβαια είναι πάρα πολλά τα οποία ίσως λέμε και μπορεί να μην προλαβαίνουμε και για την επεξήγηση, ίσως να προσπαθήσω στα αγγλικά για καλύτερη. When Arthur Rimbaud, the French poet, came to Paris and it is known his photograph before the action, τις σχισμένες αφίσες του Παρισιού.
The posters that were torn up.
Exactly, he conceived the idea of je et un autre, the idea of that I is another, not me. And from this, really, this interior, τον εσωτερικό σπαραγμό και το ξέσχισμα,
the interior torn apart and suffering.
Yes, from this, really was born the idea that I am somebody else. And not only this, but if I am somebody else, really all of us are one. Yes, this small piece of paper says a word. Και εμείς, I and we. And when we are we, really we are a universe. A universe which goes exactly to do that for which we were born. That means everything you said about freedom, love, all this energy, all this energy which gives us the way of existing, of living. And for this reason, and I'm going to stop because I speak very, very much, maybe, I am remembering, for me, it's the best definition, yes, of art that I have ever heard. It was of Robert Filliou, an artist of Fluxus. He was French, but he was a little Greek, Filliou. He said that art is that that makes life more interesting than art. It is a paradoxological definition. He said that art is that that makes life more interesting than art. That means θυσιάζει την τέχνη ακριβώς χάρη της ζωής, βάζοντας την ζωή σαν συστατικό, απόλυτο γενεσιουργό του πρώτου αρχεγόνου και αρχετύπου that you have said μέσα στην ίδια την τέχνη.
It puts life itself in the center of art, thus making life itself the quintessential part of art, like you said, an architect.
Are we living now or making art?
Yes, you ask me?
Everyone.
Yes, in my opinion, these two things are absolutely inseparable. We are living, we are making art, but if one of the two, we have to check just one, I am going to say we are living. And fortunately, life is everywhere, and it is full of joy. Even the 40 degrees centigrade, even everything that exists everywhere, we respect it. We believe that we struggle to face every difficulty, every injustice, etc., etc. But always the joy. Always a good evening outside that we will go to, that we are going to tell, to say to somebody, maybe unknown to us, it is a reason of life.
Then why all this animation?
Because, yes.
Why the animation? If the conditions are so perfect since birth, because we are born to do this, then why?
we are not perfect, we say about injustice, imperfectness, etc. Maybe we have to face them, to struggle against them. But maybe it's one of the most important lessons for us to become better, to make hypocrisy transcend.
To fight the difficulties and go above. Yeah, it's part of the metamorphosis. It's part of the... No, because it has a negative exception. No, it's part of the evolution.
Of the evolution.
Yeah,
yes. And always
the transformation. Yeah. It's very... I totally agree. It's very beautiful what you're saying. Do you feel it in here? I feel when I said that... You asked me why I was there. Because something, like somehow, my perception was telling me that something like this was going to happen. Because I have a lot of hope. And I think we need hope. And I think we should be happy to be alive. Even if sometimes people feel that they are asleep because of maybe they project themselves in something that is not real. They project themselves in they like in social network or you are like this paper is about capitalism, it's a critique about capitalism, and let's say that the virtual reality is the tissue, is the ground where capitalism can really put their roots and can really monetize everything, because it's very easy on something that doesn't really exist to make money. So if people lose the perception of their body, maybe they also lose the perception of the happiness, of the feeling of happiness.
Did we challenge capitalism today?
I think, I think that it's not to be challenged, it's not to be just be ignored. So, I don't know, I prefer ignore. Like, not, I mean, it's so big that how can you, I don't know, it's, I don't know. But what do you think? Are we challenging capitalism now?
Ακριβώς η ερώτηση είναι αν προκαλούμε τον καπιταλισμό challenge.
Άμα τον... προκαλώ, αλλά με την έννοια του να προκαλέσουμε για μία αλλαγή.
Μάλιστα. Δύσκολη η κάθε αλλαγή, δυστυχώς. Επιβάλλεται να μην μείνουμε με σταυρωμένα χέρια. We have to struggle against, of course, yes, because everything in our life is full of injustice, imperfectness, that you said before, of course. And we have to face it, yes. Maybe, and Mr. wants to say something.
Let's strike.
What are you striking for?
Thinking.
Is thinking a form of labor?
No, it's a form of life.
So you're striking from life?
At the moment, yes.
We are living now, so like what is striking life? Striking life is not living.
It's more about taking a break from what you normally do. I mean, maybe it's more about doing a new life rather than your regular life.
So you would not be able to breathe if you strike life.
So you're still living, you're just not doing something that you don't like to do.
No, I'm breathing with green hair as alternative.
You're breathing?
I'm breathing the green hair.
Yeah.
It's something that I don't usually do. So I would think so. I haven't been working for these past few days and I'm experiencing something else, right? So yeah, something different from my normal life. So that's why I don't think normally what I'm thinking, let's say.
Does something change in your life when you enter this space?
I think the problem right now is that we are trying to be against something, but that something that something may be different from everybody, like your biggest enemy is not my biggest enemy, let's say, but it's a social intervention. What we're trying to be against would be something collective, and it would be quite hard to define at the moment, actually. Just in this room, I may be thinking about something that I don't agree with in a different setting than the things that I'm not agree with in my normal setting. So let's say the politics here is completely different from the politics I'm experiencing usually every day, for example. So as a dissonance, I think it's a bit hard to define. So I like the fact that AC is not working, being very hot, being kind of the common ground in this room that we share. I don't know if we should take some suggestion from Gaza, let's say, and see what they think could be a collective act that we could do over here. And there has been quite a controversial, you know, discussion about documenta being Athens and da da da. I don't know if I should go there, so can we ask council? Maybe they have some suggestions what we can do.
There is no one world history,
there's not even one local industry. So I guess it really depends on groups of people, and maybe it's not individuals, but at least groups of people.
Even though there wasn't such a big crowd, but the message did get along. I'm not sure if it can actually work in these conditions. I was feeling very dizzy half the time. We should stay on strike more.
So that we can go on strike? Because I thought strike was a notion that had to do with labor.
Yeah, but maybe like if you strike in order to like have some more rights, for example, or to defend your rights, or to like in order to achieve something. But if you don't have anything to achieve, what are you striking for? So that conditioning is the point.
And without purpose.
Yeah.
But everything is a continuity. That means even the pause in the music, it's a very, very important part of music. Or for example, when we stop in a journey, this stop in a station, it is an important piece of the journey itself. For this reason, and if we say that it's not only to be silent, I agree, it's not only to be silent to make a strike, it is not only to be absent, to leave the place to make a strike, because absence and silence are part of our existence. That means it is a part of the life. That means in that point of view, we can say